a small driving test on the tractor before you use it on the road.
It's bad news for the teenager. We're not going to, and you're not going to on the test. Alright, you have to pass the test first before you're at the clear driving us on the road. What I need to do is pop in the back of the vehicle, okay? The same thing, you may have a defense, if you don't mention that or something that you may should be around the court, anything you do, same thing, you give me an edge. Do you agree with that?
No.
The fact that we seized in section 165 of the road traffic act, it's going to be a cost of £105 and £12 a day.
£12 a day?
I think it's left there, yeah.
Oh, God. The fact that there's powers on, you know?
How do you keep the powers on? Well, the tractor.
Well, then, you know, Walker.
The tractor is more important to this young man than your everyday car. And PC Duane has to make a decision about what the boss' long-term solution is going to be.
Do you want to answer it?
Hang on, this piece of place on that.
Hello, it's passing here from our first station. Now, from what side do you need the tractor to feed your animals? What I'm willing to do is, if you can get here or somebody who's qualified to drive the tractor, I'd be quite happy for it to go back to the farm.
Right, on its way. The young lad's predicament has fallen into the right hands. PC Duane's farming roots mean that he's sure about the best way to deal with this.
How long about the tractor then?
2 months, my dad.
Are you up
there? Yeah. I think it was spinning,
right? No, that's all right. Such a bunch. I haven't found out that. This is one now, is it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Well, I should find all the seeds in the vehicle. I don't want to do that. I wouldn't get a seat tonight if I knew you were animals weren't getting down. So, you've made reasonable steps if I'm collected. I'm happy with that. I know you're driving it again today, and I'm sure you'll be driving it until you get the circle. You know you went to the fences, you didn't actually charge it anything call it community policing. At the end of the day, if I was to charge him for that, he would have lost his license. They just fought out a lot of money on a vehicle that they're trying to make money back on. I would have stopped him from his tracks, and I didn't really want to do that. 16-year-old boy who's keen to work out after his own farming. We don't want to come on it down there.
Back in Carmarthenshire, PC Ching Yip is attending a potentially explosive incident. A volatile gas canister is trapped under a car. Everyone holds their breath as the fire service begin an attempt to lift the car. The gas canister is badly damaged. If they get this wrong, the massive pressure inside could cause an explosion. But the fire service managed to remove it safely. The gas canister has been secured, but the lorry driver is still shaken up.
Yeah.
With the danger averted, the roads are opened again, and PC Ching Yip is left to deal with the drivers.
I said a very lucky cat, didn't you? I can see he had his shop in the back of the car, so he was obviously on his way home. And I imagine the last thing on his shop in this room was that similar coming towards him. And then being lodged in the car. So lucky for him, as you said, he's unhurt. And I could just get a bit of minor damage to his car.
50 miles away on the roads of Pembrokeshire, PC Paddy Duane has found himself another bizarre traffic incident. He's noticed a pickup with a slightly unusual load fastened to the back. It soon becomes apparent that the canoe is hiding the real danger here.
Probably guess why we're stopping up.
Two people are sitting in the back, and that is against the law.
Not very good, is it?
No.
Hello. You the driver? Not a good move, this.
With no belt and no overhead protection, if this truck had overturned, that would have been a double fatality.
It would be horrendous if you were in an accident. You could imagine what would happen if you were in a bump, couldn't it?
The passenger and his wife know they've done wrong.
My wife said, don't do it, and it's really said it, so don't blame her.
Very sensible lady, then.
They're lucky that a stern warning is all they get.
Do something again. There we are. She obviously knows best, doesn't she? There we are, then. Now we go on your way. Right. So we'll be back to it. She wasn't happy about him being in there.
Yeah.
He's from the new sister. I know he's in trouble, isn't he?
Eagle-eyed PC Dwayne only manages a few miles down the road before he spots another potential problem. It's a small one.